Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My sons and daughters, today, inshallah, I will start to present a new chapter, chapter 4, which is titled is Transportation in a Supply Chain. The first point of this chapter is determining what are the role of transportation in a supply chain. The first is it's a more vital economic activity in any business because it helps for moving the goods from the location of the company to be inside the location of the markets. And at the same time, it helps as essential part for linking between a company and their suppliers and their customers. Also, it can help as essential activity also in the logistics function by achieving the place utility and time utility. As we mentioned in the first chapter, yes, to provide the products at the time needed and to provide the products at the most recent location to the customers. Another point, which is this type of transportation, refers to that managing this transportation with a good management. It can help for ensuring the high delivery performance achieved, and the customer satisfaction already is achieved. Here, the last point, transportation. Playing also critical role in case of the management, they can plan for managing effective transportation inside its company by working with inventory planners, which lead to improve the efficiency using the warehouse and keeping only the units needed according to the requirements of the markets and according to the requirements of the production system. So here you will find that we can save money on storage. This page refers to that transportation overview. You will find that transportation in general provides a flow of material, products, persons between production facilities, warehouses, distribution centers, terminal and the customer locations, and we said this before. And also we said that transportation as activity inside inside the organization consumes a major proportion, which is like 1/3 of the total logistics cost. Also, this type of points is mentioned in the first chapter. Okay, so you can find that transportation is critical and it's a crucial point, a crucial activity inside the organization. And transportation planning targets. What about these targets of transportation planning? Three targets here we needed to achieve it. The first one here in the first first column here, like we mentioned, customer satisfaction, or providing high quality of service. The second is improving the productivity by achieving productivity efficiency, and the last one, which is minimizing the cost in general. I'm starting in the first one, customer satisfaction. Customer satisfaction here, yes, the customers needed to deliver the products at the time needed. The second is we needed to minimize the delaying time and providing the products at the time like we said before, the time achieving the time utility and reducing the damage of the units through transportation and losses. Losses here, it means that don't leave the customer to ask about a certain products and then the answer is I'm sorry, it's not available. No, Here, the customers will not ask about this type of product again from this location, but maybe he can search for the substitute for buying it. The second point, which is productivity, efficiency. This can be achieved by reducing the transit time. It means that through the time of transportation, reducing the time transit between the different type of locations, this is will lead to transport the products with lower time, and the cost for this type of transit will be low. Cost minimization, yes. The transportation managing efficiency of transportation activities may be lead for reducing fuel consumption, minimizing the overtime, minimizing the personal cost, which is responsible for driving the transportation modes, and at the same time, the vehicle acquisition. Yes, we needed that to minimize its cost. So all of this type of targets is needed in case of talking about transportation plan. Types of transport modes. You will find inside this type of page, yes, there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, this page can describe five types of transportation modes. In the first, which is air, the second is sea, the third is rail, the fourth will be road, and the last one, number five, which is pipeline. For the first one here, you will find that air, yes, in general, air is expensive, but at the same time, it can provide short-time transporting, and it can transport the products for long distance. But it will be under certain problems, which is maybe it's delaying for departure from yani from the location because of the weather conditions. C is the second one. Yes, C here can carry large quantities of quantities using tons to measure these quantities. Okay, by using ships. Yes, and these ships can offer low flexibility in determining routes and schedules because it will be under the pressures and under the problems of the weather conditions. Okay. Real. So before starting to talk about real, be sure that air and sea, each of them, they will be under problems in case of will be have a certain impact because of the weather conditions, so the delaying will be done. Also, the C here is also has a certain points which is difficult here, because maybe it needs to yani to wait in according to transit points because of its routes and its schedules. Okay. But in case of talking about rail and roads, pipelines, all of them in the first time, like here, which are written with different color, weather conditions don't influence about the rail, about the roads, and about the pipelines. Okay, this is the first, and then we will talk about rail with details. Yes, rail transportation is slow. Okay. Usually, it's low cost material, okay? And raw material are usually transferred, okay? Many stops in local areas. Take care, local areas, okay? Can be made in order to load and unload commodities, okay? To put the products inside the rail. Or to handle this type of products from the rail to be inside the warehouse. Okay, you will find that another one of this, which is road here is, yes, This is based on what about the infrastructures here, which is very critical points in case of talking about the roads. And it will needed to lower capacity, to carry lower capacity or quantity. Yes, it has a certain advance which is can provide the products to be to offer door to door. Okay, by using a certain specialized vehicles. Okay, like trucks or like motors or others. What about for the pipelines? The pipelines here is used according to a certain type of to transport or to carry a certain type of products, liquids or gases, oil, natural gases like here, more suitable for the type of petrol company to transport its products. It works for 24 hours a day. And at the same time, it can transport, yes, transportation is slow, but it can transport the products to a certain destination, which is lying between 3 to 4 miles per hour, okay? As in rail transport, offers spaces network, specific stops or intersections between different type of lines. Okay, this is in general the general information about the type of transportation modes and little description about each one of them. You will find for this type of page, yes, an indicative comparison of transport modes. For this type of page, you will find that this type, the first, you have to understand in the first column here the type of modes, rail, road, sea, air, pipelines, okay. And at the same time, there is number of factors which are used to compare between this type of transportation modes. This type of factors, they are number one, cost, delivery time, geographical coverage, loss, and number four, loss and damage. Okay. And for comparing between this type of transportation modes, according to this type of factors used to compare between them, we will depend on a certain scale. The cost will having a certain scale lying between 1 to 5. 1 refers to cheap and 5 refers to expensive. Delivery time, we can use another type of scale, fast or slow. Fast will have, will have 1, slow will have 5. Geographical coverage, yes. Another scale will be used, good or poor. Good refers to, 1 refers to good, but 5 refers to poor. Loss and damage, yes, another scale will be used, which is safest is indicator to the, yes, to the highest level of the safe, and the 5 refers to least safe. Based on this type of factor, we needed to understand what about the what about the contents of this type of table. Yeah, in case of the rail here, rail, road, sea, air, and one line. According to the cost, you will find that the sea is the sea is the cheapest one. The sea, and then the pipeline, and then the rail, and then the roads, and the expensive one is the air. Do you understand the meaning? What do you mean by this arrangement according to the cost? Okay, what about the delivery time? Logic, you can see the delivery time, air, yes, is the is the fast one. Okay, then the roads, yes, then the rail, then the pipeline, and the last one will be the sea. Okay, what about the geographical coverage? The geographical coverage here, yes, the first one, which is the sea. Sea can cover different type of geographical regions, and then it will be the rail, because but rail here, it can cover the geographical coverage in the local in the local market. Okay, And then number C, the air. And number four, which is roads. Okay, and number five, which the most poor geographical coverage, the pipeline. What about for the losses and damage? Here you will find that pipeline is the most safest one of this type of modes. Okay, and then the sea, and then air, and then the road. And the least safe is the rail. Do you understand the meaning? And because the, this is maybe maybe it's under the infra under the smoothing roads of the under the I'm sorry losses and damage for this rail is the least safe because maybe it will be under accidents or maybe under different type of difficult through busing to different type of cities inside the country. Okay, based on this type of data you have to understand, yes, what about the most, what about the most factor can affect the moods, what about the least factor, what about the other factors which can impact the least impact. Do you understand the meaning? And then we can arrange this type of factors according to the transportation modes. Okay. The components of transport systems. Here, try to be sure that the first column here refers to what about these components of transport system. This transport network can be separated into three categories. The first one, which is facilities, the second, which is equipment, and the third, which is people. And this is needed in case of talking about the transport system. Okay? The transport system consists of three types of factors: facilities, equipment, and people. What's the difference between them? The first, here you can understand that the facilities here is fixed components. Okay? Maybe it can classify into two types, which is specific or common facilities. The specific facilities here is warehouses, terminal, distribution centers, hubs, docks, okay, specific. But in case of talking about the common facilities, it's the roadways, it's the rail tracks, and waterways. Please, you can understand what about the examples for each one of these specific or the common. The equipment here is the different type of parts of transportation network, okay? And is the here we are talking about the type of equipment which are maintained by the shippers or the carriers. Like what? The containers, trailers, vehicles here like trucks or scooters, rail cars or locomotives, aircrafts or vessels. All of them, they are different type of equipments which are used by the shippers or the carriers. The people in the last one, which is people, is the persons who are working as supportive functions, are one of the crucial components of the transportation networks. So here, take care. We needed to differentiate between two types of this, point of this of the people. Okay, we needed to understand. In the first one, which is people, they are involved in transportation related or transportation supportive functions. Okay, yes, they are playing as supportive functions. Then. Related to work, you will find that this type of people, they are one of these type of forms. Maybe they are working position like operating personnel, like drivers, pilots, and others. Related working positions, operating personnel. The second is supportive personnel. Supportive personnel persons who are responsible for maintaining the equipments, or responsible for loading the products to be inside the transportation mode, or to handle the products from the transportation mode to be inside the warehouse or the location of the retailer or wholesaler. And the third one of this type of persons, managerial personnel. Managerial personnel, they are logistics directors or dispatchers or administration system. Okay, so please take care. All the people working in the transportation department, they are this type of transportation department, they are working as supportive functions. Okay, these types of people, they are having three forms. The first one related the working positions, okay, which are called operating personnel. The second, which are working as supportive personnel, and the third, which are working as managerial personnel. Okay, and each one of them having a certain examples. Okay, special carriers and the third party, okay, of logistics. Here in this page, you will find that different type of special here, special carriers. Okay, like freight forwards. Shippers Association, Freight Brokers, Container Leasing Company, and Freight Audit or Payments. Okay, so what about for the first? The freight forwards here is an intermediary. Like here, I'm putting a certain line under a certain point, which is referring to the direct definition for this type of these special carriers for each of one. Freight forwards, yeah, they are is an intermediary. Okay, provides a wide range of logistics services. They are providing logistics services. What about these logistics services here? They are moving the certain cargo or products or commodities from its point of origin. Its point of origin, maybe it's the supplier company, or maybe it's the warehouse of the manufacturing system. Okay, to its final destination. This final destination may be, in case of talking about transporting or moving the cargo from the supplier's companies, so the final destination will be the company warehouse. Or from, in case of talking about move the certain cargo from the point of origin, like the warehouse of the company, so the final destination will be the location of the buyers. Okay, via a single or multiple carriers. Okay, via air, marine, rail, or highway. Okay, take care about each one of these concepts. Okay. The second one here is Shippers Association. The Shippers Association here, it's refers to non-profit transportation membership cooperatives. Okay, they are responsible for a range for the domestic or international shipments. Okay, non-profit transportation membership cooperatives arrange the domestic or international shipments of members' cargo. Okay. Okay, what about for the freight brokers? The freight brokers is different because they are responsible for arranging the transportation and tracking of a load. Tracking of a load. Okay, arranging the transportation and tracking of a load. Okay, they make it easier for shippers to find quality carriers that are proven to be reliable in hauling a load. Okay, track, they are arranging the transportation and tracking of a load, okay, by freight carriers. The container leasing company. What about for this container leasing company? The containers here is using for many long-term lease agreements. Okay, yes, there is negotiations which allows the rental rates can be negotiated after a few years. This few years, we are lying between 5 and 8 years, okay? In light of depreciation and market volatility. Here we need to understand that these containers can be under leasing for a certain type of years, okay? And this is based on the depreciation and the market volatility, okay? This time of long-term leasing of these containers is lying between 5 and 8 years, okay? The freight audit payments. The freight audit or payments, here a freight audit is a business process. A business process where the company's freight bills are examined. Do you understand the meaning here? Yeah, we needed to understand that the freight audit. It means it's a business process. That the company's freight bills are examined and adjusted and verified for accuracy. So here the explanation refers to that if errors are found on the shipper's invoice. Okay, if there is errors on the shipper's invoice, their chosen freight audit and payment company to reach out of the carrier to ensure that it's corrected and a new invoice is issued. Okay, please take care. You will find that this type of special carriers, they are different. Each one of them is different from others. I'm starting with the first one, freight forwarders, which refers to, yes, intermediary to move the certain cargo from its point of origin to the final destination. Do you understand? By using a single or multiple carriers. And it's shippers association. Yes, it's a non-profit transportation membership cooperative. Okay, this is will be used to arrange this type of shipments domestically or internationally. The freight brokers, no, they are responsible for another type of points, which is responsible for arranging the transportation and tracking the loads. Do you understand the meaning? Okay. Container leasing company, yeah, company, okay. Here, we are talking about the containers itself, okay. Yes, maybe be leased for long term, maybe lying between 5 and 8 years. This is based on the depreciation and the market volatility, okay. And the last one, like we said now, the freight audit or payment. This is a certain process which are needed to examine the company's freight bills and to be sure that it's accurate or not. And then we can depend on a certain type of freight audit, which already responsible for finding the errors of the shipper's invoice in case of it's already there is errors, and at the same time to be sure that the new one of the invoice is issued. Okay. This current page includes a certain problem which explain how a company can use a certain methods to choose between the types of transportation modes. Okay, you will find that this type of problem having a certain data which refers to that shipments of parts valued at $7,500 needs to be shipped from Tampa to Chicago. Okay, and this could be shipped by rail or by truck. Okay, by rail or by truck. Okay, this company collected data about in case of this shipments can be shipped by rail, it needs 15 days to transport them, and can lead to have a certain cost which is equal 1,575. But in case of using truck to transport, it can take 5 days to transport this shipment, and the cost that can be achieved is $2,640. Also, this company collect data about the annual holding cost rate for this type of item, which can be estimated at 22% from the value of this shipment. Also, the data given here is assume that this company works 365 days yearly. And the question here is, what option is more economical, to depend on rail or to depend on truck to transport this shipment? Okay, think here. Economical here, it means that we needed to transport these shipments with minimization of the cost. Okay, and based on this type of data, you will find that here, to find the solution for this type of problem, you will start for calculating the first daily cost of holding the item. The daily cost of holding these items, holding inventory of this item. Do you understand the meaning here? Okay. You will depend on this 22%. As mentioned, 22% estimated from the value of this shipment, 0.22 times the value of this shipment, which is equal $7,500. Okay, this is will be over the number of days working yearly, which is equal 365 days. Okay, you will find that the cost, the daily cost of holding these items will be $45.21. Okay. So, what about for the number of days can be saved in case of using the truck? Because the truck here, the number of days is lower than the number of days of rail transportation. So, you will find that 15 days to transport using rail minus 5 days for transporting these shipments using truck. 15 minus 5, you will find that 11 days can be saved in case of using truck to transport. Okay. Okay. What about the cost saving by using this truck? The cost saving by using this truck will be, yes, 11 days. Okay. And these 11 days, you will save a certain daily cost of holding. Okay. Which is equal. Yes. 45.21, this is the cost of holding. Okay, so you can calculate the cost saving by using the trucks. By using trucks, we can save 11 days. So this is means that there is 11 days, refers to 11 days to hold these items as inventory. What about its cost? Its cost will be equal 11 days times the 45.21, which is equal $497.27. Okay. So, what about the etc. shipping cost? What about the etc. shipping cost? The etc. shipping cost is what about the highest cost minus the lowest cost of transportation modes used? The highest cost here, in case of yes, the cost of transporting the products using truck, which is equal $2,640. Minus, what about the cost for transporting the same products using the rail, which is equal 1,575. Okay, so the subtraction between them can refers to what about the etc. shipping cost in case of using the trucks. Truck can save days, but at the same time, it's a higher cost in case of comparing with the rail cost. Okay. So here the saving cost will be 1.065. We can find this type of data. Yes, we can save it. Yeah, we can save it in case of using rail, but at the same time it will be etc. cost in case of using the truck to transport the products. Okay, do you understand the meaning? Okay. So now we needed to trade off between the cost of saving by using truck and the etc. shipping cost by using truck. Do you understand? Do you understand here? Okay. So, you will find that this cost saving by using truck, it's not matching and it's not offset the etc. shipping cost of using these trucks. Okay, so it's better to recommend to this type of company. It's more economical for transporting these products using rail as a transportation mode. Okay, point needed as the distribution network or designing the distribution network. Okay, the first one here is in case of this type of company needed to direct shipments network to a single destination. What do you mean by them? According to this type of figure, which refers to that maybe there is more than one supplier's companies, but each supplier here can send direct its shipments, yes, to the buyer, to a certain buyer locations. Here, according to this type of title, all shipments come direct from each supplier to each buyer locations. Okay, maybe one supplier can send this shipments, its shipments to location one, location two, location three, location four. Okay, separately. Okay, direct relation between each supplier and each buyer location. Okay, and this is will be needed in case of the demand at buyer locations is large enough. Okay, the demand at buyer locations is large enough, or this store is large stores. Okay, please take care in case of using this direct shipments network, which you can need it to transport any products from each supplier to each buyer location, like this type of firm. So direct shipments needed or can be preferred in case of what about this assumption? In case of the demand at buyer location is large enough. Okay, the demand rates for this type of buyer locations is a high demand. Okay, and this type of store is large store. Okay, that optimal replenishment lot sizes are close to the truckload from each supplier to each location. Each one of this truck will be complete load to transport it from each supplier to each buyer location, and this is will be done under a certain condition or under a certain assumption, which is the demand rates at a buyer locations is large enough. Okay, what about the advantages can be achieved in case of talking about the direct shipments network? Okay, or like we said here, single destination. It can be eliminate the intermediate warehouses. Okay, there is no intermediaries here, but direct relation. Okay, and the simplicity of operation, the coordination between the suppliers and the buyers locations. This is will be done in case of this type of destination is completely local. Locally. It's done locally, okay? And doesn't influence others. And the transportation time is short. Do you understand the meaning? Transportation, this means that the destination between the suppliers and buyer location is short time. The destination is the short destination between the suppliers and their buyer location. Okay, in the second one here is all shipments via intermediate distribution center with storage. You will find that according to this figure, this type of relation between the suppliers and the buyer locations is done through the distribution centers. Do you understand? With storage. Here, what happened here? The product is shipped from suppliers to a central distribution first. Okay? Why? To store it first. Until it's needed by buyers when it's shipped to each buyer location. You understand? So the suppliers will be shipping their products to put it inside the distribution centers to store them. Till the buyers need it, so this distribution center will start to ship these products to each supplier, to each buyer locations. Okay, At what condition this type of network is needed? It's needed in case of the supply chain needed to achieve economics of scales. For inbound, what about for this inbound? The inbound transportation, it means that the transporting the products from the suppliers' companies to be inside the distribution centers. And to a point close to the final destination, okay? And this distribution center is more, is a point close to a final destination of the buyer locations. And this distribution center is nearest to the buyer locations, okay? Okay. Serve, this type of distribution centers serve locations nearby. Do you understand the nearby? Nearby, it means that the destination between the distribution centers and the buyer locations is very low destination, okay? And the outbound transportation cost is not very large. So in case of the destination between the distribution centers and the location of these buyers is a short distance, so the cost of transportation also will be low. You understand? Okay. What about for the third? The third one here is the cross-docking. The cross-docking here is another one of this network relationship between the supply chains. What about for the, what do you mean by this? The first, what do you mean by this cross-docking? The cross-docking here is logistics strategy. Okay, when cargo or products or commodities is immediately unloaded from an incoming container and then loaded directly to an outbound. What do you mean by this? Here, yes, there is distribution warehouse. Yes. But this distribution warehouse is used, okay, without storing the products inside it. Listen to me here. This cross-docking, it means that, yes, the suppliers send their shipments to an intermediate transit point. The transit point here, yes. So the distribution center here is playing as a transit point, okay? And direct sent to a buyer locations without storing them. So the shipments here is not stored. There is no storage, okay, at the intermediate facility. It's used only as a transit point, okay, intermediate transit point, as a transit point. Maybe I can, this type of distribution center here receiving this shipments and staging it less than 24 hours. Do you understand? It's not stored. It's only as a transit point for less than 24 hours and then shipping again. Do you understand? Okay, please take care. We are presenting till now three types of the network between the suppliers and the buyer locations. We are presenting in the first time the direct shipping, and this direct shipping will be done according to a certain assumption, which is the store of this type of buyer location is large enough, or the demand rates for this type of stores is large enough. Okay, what about for the second network? The second network is yes, all the shipments will be transported to be inside the warehouse. This warehouse is used to store the products, okay, till it will be transported again to the buyers, but under a certain assumption. What about this assumption? Is the destination between the distribution center and the buyer locations is short time, okay, so the transportation cost will be also low. The cross-docking is different, because the cross-docking here, it means that we needed to use an intermediate transit point, okay? So the suppliers send their shipments to an intermediate transit point. This means that these distribution centers will be receiving these shipments and keeping it for less than 24 hours, less than one day. Do you understand? And direct shipping to the buyers. Okay? This page refers to tailored network. You will find that according to what's mentioned now, We are presenting already direct chubbing. All chubbments via central distribution center to store, or using the cross docking as a transit point. According to this network structures, you will find that there is options to support or to pros this type of network, and there is cons, or maybe they are against this type of network structures. Okay, so what about the positive and negative points for each one of this type of network structuring? According to the first one, direct chubbing, yes, the advantage here is or to support them, because it's there is no intermediate warehouse, but there is direct relationship between the suppliers or the company and their suppliers locations, okay, and their buyer locations, which is simplifying the coordination and direct relation between the suppliers and the buyer locations. But at the same time, maybe this is lead to large lot size and to keep a high level of inventory inside this type of buyer locations. Okay. In case of talking about all achievements via distribution centers as a storage point, you can find that this is will lead to reduce the inbound transportation, the cost of transport the products from the suppliers to be inside this distribution centers through the consolidations. It means that this type of distribution center will be as a center for receiving different type of shipments from the different type of suppliers at one time. Okay, so the cost here of transporting the inbound transportation will be low. In other side here, yes, increasing the inventory cost, increasing the handling at distribution center. It means that increasing the number of units as consolidation shipments from the suppliers to be inside the distribution center for time till it will be demanded from the buyer locations. This means that the cost of inventory will be high, okay, and at the same time the cost of handling this inventory to be inside the trucks also will be high. All achievements in the third, all achievements via cross docking and using this distribution center as transit point, intermediate transit point, lower than number of 24 hours, like you said, from minutes. What about the advanced points here? It's needed to low inventory requirements, yes, lower transportation cost through consolidation, and at the same time here you have to understand that this type of shipments, it's unloaded and loaded again direct to be inside the buyer locations. Okay, so the inventory the inventory carrying cost and the inventory holding cost will be low, because the time of keeping this type of shipments inside the distribution center as transit points will very very low, because it's only number of hours till it will be transported again. The against of this type of network, they say that this is maybe lead to increase the coordination complexity, because the large numbers of this transportation will be done, and as soon as this type of consolidations will be reached to this or received inside the transit point, it will be needed again to transport again using trucks or different transportation modes to transport it again to the buyer locations. It's not easy. Maybe this type of process will be lead to increase the complexity of this process. Okay, the last one here is tailored network. What do you mean by this tailored network as pro and or as cons? Here you will find that transportation choice best matches needs of individual product and store. Transportation choice best matches needs of individual product and store. Do you understand? But here you will find that also a high coordination complexity in case of using this. Okay. Now we another type of methods used for selecting a transportation network. Okay, transportation network here, which is different from the first problem given inside this chapter from number of pages, which already needed to compare between two types of transportation modes, rail or trucks. But here, this problem is different because here we needed to compare between the transportation networks and which one of them will be better for choosing. Okay, here we are concentrating about the direct shipping. Okay, direct shipping, and we needed to find what about this total annual cost of direct network. This problem refers to that the vice president of supply chain is considering to use direct shipping from suppliers to retail stores. Okay, a certain direct shipping from suppliers to retail stores. And if the annual sales or annual demand for each product at each retail stores are 960,000 units, okay? And there are 8 stores. Listen, there are 8 stores and 4 sources of suppliers. And the truck capacity here refers to that the batch size which needed to ship from each supplier to each store is estimated as 40,000 units. And the transportation cost per load is $1,000, and the delivery cost per load is $100, and the holding cost per unit yearly is $0.2. Okay, take care here about a certain point. We needed to understand there is number of sources or number of suppliers, VR4, and needed to make a certain network to ship their shipments to 8 location of buyers or 8 locations of stores. Okay, and this 8 stores, each one of them needed the annual demand for each product at each retail store is equal 960,000 units, and at the same time each time for shipping the batch size from each supplier to each store is 40,000 units. And here different type of cost giving. Yes, the transportation cost, the delivery cost, the holding cost per unit, and all of them given. And the main question here is what's the total annual cost of direct shipping network. Okay, to answer about this question, you needed to be sure that what about the assumption for this type of this direct network. The direct network, it means that this store its demand rates is high quantity, and at the same time this location of this stores is large enough to keep this type of shipments. So each supplier will use a certain truck under a certain assumption, full truck loads. Do you understand? All the truck is complete, it's a full truck loads, okay, for shipping it from each supplier to each retail stores. What about the steps here needed to solve this type of problem? The first one here, we needed to understand what about the number of shipments per year from each supplier to each store. Okay, the number of shipments needed. So what about the total annual sales? Yes, what about the total annual sales or annual demand at each retail store? Yes, over the batch size which is needed to transport for each one of this network between supplier and each stores of buyers. So we can divide this 960,000 over 40,000. It will be 24 times. This means that this transportation will be done 424 times to transport these total units, okay? And according to said, it will be transported 40,000 units each time. So what about the annual tracking cost for direct shipping? Okay, what about the annual tracking cost? The annual tracking cost here as direct shipping, it will be, yes, we will transport 24 times, okay? Each time, each one of this time needed transportation cost per load, which is $1,000, and the delivery cost per load, which is 100, okay, which is equal $1,100. This is will be transported between, yes, eight stores, and from four sources of suppliers, yes, times four. You understand? Okay, so this is will be the total annual cost for direct network, okay, $844,800. What about the average inventory at each store for each product? The average inventory, take care, we are not calculating the annual inventory cost till we needed to calculate first what about the average inventory. So the annual inventory cost will be depending on calculating the average inventory first. The average inventory at each store for each product will be the average. It means that what about this batch size over two? It will be 20,000 units. Okay. What about the annual inventory cost for this direct network? It will be, yes, 20,000 times. What about the cost of holding, which is equal 0.2? Okay, times. This will be come from four sources of suppliers to eight stores. Okay, so the total cost will be $128,000. Then we can calculate the total annual cost of direct network by finding the summation between the annual tracking cost of direct network plus the annual inventory cost of direct network here, and then the total cost will be $972,800. Okay, so we can calculate this the cost of this transportation network by having different type of information about the annual sales needed or annual demand needed from each store, and what about the number of stores and the number of sources of suppliers, what about the batch size which you can needed to full truck loads for each truck capacity. So here the truck capacity to be full truck loads is needed 400,000 units, and needed to give information about the transportation cost per load, the delivery cost per load, and the holding cost per load, per unit. And at the end we can find what about the total cost to find yes, this is good or bad to use or to reject. Okay, another method used for trading off the cost to select the transportation mode. You will find another type of data given here. Yes, the annual demand, the cost per unit, the weight for this product, the lot size, the safety stock, the holding cost per unit, the transportation cost per unit, the lead time per days, the in-transit inventory per days, and the number of days working yearly. According to this type of problem, different type of data given here. The annual demand is 120,000. The cost per unit is $120. The lot size is 2,000. The weight is 10 per motor. The safety stock is equal 50%. The holding cost per unit is equal $30, and the transportation cost per unit is $0.65. The lead time per days is 6 days, and in transit inventory per days is 5 days, and the number of days working yearly is 365. according to all these type of data, you needed to find what about the cost which is used for determining this transportation mode can be used or not. Okay, you will find that this type of page refers to what about the equations used for calculating the problem and to find the total annual cost for inventory. Like here, yes, we needed to say, yes, what about this? We needed to calculate the total, we needed to calculate the total annual cost for inventory. Yes, the total, yes, here, the total annual cost for inventory, okay, and transportation using a certain type of this mode, okay. This is we needed to calculate the annual transportation cost by using a certain mode plus the annual holding cost. You understand? So the summation between each of them will lead to the calculate the total annual cost for inventory and transportation by using this type of mode, okay, of transportation mode. How calculating this first? How calculating the annual holding cost? The annual holding cost is needed to find it here. Yes, what about for this annual transportation cost? This is will be the equal, yes, equal the summation between all these type of calculations. You understand? The safety, yes, here, number one, the safety inventory, yes, yeah, the safety inventory, the safety, and the cost, the inventory transit, okay, and the total average, okay. And here you will find that the to find and the cycle inventory, okay, the summation between each of them, like here, yes, the cycle, take care, yes, the cycle, yes, the cycle, the safety, and the safety inventory and in transit inventory. The calculations, the summation between all of them, they can lead for achieving this total average inventory. And after calculating them, you will find the holding cost by using these modes. You can find the total average inventory times the holding cost per unit. And the annual transportation cost will be equal the annual demand times the transportation cost per unit. Okay. Try to use the data given in the previous page to solve this type of problem. What about this point? You will find that, yes, we needed here, like we given from minutes, we needed, yes, we needed to find, we needed first to calculate number one, we needed to calculate the cycle inventory, and number two, we needed to calculate the safety inventory, and number three, we needed to calculate the, yes, we need to calculate this in transit inventory, and then the summation between them for finding, yes, like here, the total inventory cost. The first one is here, how to find the cycle inventory. The cycle inventory is the here the lot size or the Q over 2. The lot size here is 2000 according to the data given. This is will be over 2. This which leads to 1000 motors. Okay, the results. The second is safety inventory. How calculating this safety inventory? The safety inventory is equal. Okay, what about this? The lead time here over 2. The lead time here according to the data given is 6 days. So 6 days as lead time over 2 to find the average lead time. The result will be times the results of division between the annual demand as given over the number of days working for this type of company, 365 days. So the results will be 968 motors. Okay, so the safety inventory is equal the lead time over 2 times the annual demand over the number of days working. So what about the next one, number 3, in transit inventory? In transit inventory is equal, yes, the annual demand times the results of the division of the number of days as transit number of days, 5 days, over the number of working days yearly, 365 days. So the results will be 1,644. Based on this type of three types of inventory, inventory as a cycle inventory, inventory as a safety inventory, inventory as in transit inventory. So the summation between all these type of results is like here. Yes, this is will be 1,000 here. In the second, yes. It's not this, yes, this is the second, yes. And the third here will be, okay. This is will be the total. According to this type of information, the total average inventory. How calculating the cost of this holding inventory? Yes, by giving this type of total average inventory times the cost of holding inventory per unit, $30 per unit. This is will be the result, 108.900. Okay. And then calculating the annual cost of transportation for using this type of real modes, it will be annual demand times the cost of transportation per load. Okay, so the results between them will be equal 7,800,000 dollars, and summation between this type of data. Yes, the summation between this type of information. Yes. Okay, so what about the results? The results will be here. Okay, the next one of this page refers to the risk management in transportation. What about this risk management in transportation? Here you will find that three types of risk can be considered in case of talking about the transportation management. Okay, maybe this shipment is delaying. Okay. Delaying at the time needed to deliver this type of shipments. Okay, the second is the risk of disruptions, and this disruptions, it means that the efficiency of traffic information delivery. Okay, and the third, which is maybe this material is hazardous, maybe it's a harm, and maybe it leads to problems in case of something happened through transporting. Okay, this is three forms. Shipments may be delayed, or maybe there's disruptions of this type of inefficiency of traffic information delivery, or maybe the material transported, maybe it's hazardous, or maybe it's a harm. Okay, you will find for this type of page transforming future of logistics and transportation. Okay, The transformation future of logistics and transportation, according to the future, inshallah, according to this digitized tracking 2025, this is for the future planning for logistics and transportation. It needed for using another type of forms like drones and robotics, like integrated automated process for each one of this system and process for the supply chain, and depends on gathering data and the data analytics. Okay, using clouds for storing the information, and maybe depending on autonomous trucks and blockchain. Each one of these type of points refers to that there is a transformation future for the transportation modes will be used in supply chain management. And here I will present a little data about the cloud. What do you mean by this cloud? Cloud, it means that yes, cloud-based services can connect to everyone in the supply chain. Okay, to provide a strategic approach for inventory deployment. What about for this geo analytics? Cloud computing can enable supply chain management to monitor delivery network and prioritize slow moving shipments. Okay. to understand this type of cloud, we needed to know what about the benefits can be achieved in case of using these clouds in the supply chain system or for managing the supply chain management. Cloud logistics was founded as alternative to traditional slow-moving, high-priced, yes, it's a high-cost transportation management system. Yes, it can enable, okay, for managing the system of warehouse and enabling higher supply chain performance by optimizing the order shipments and production planning across the whole warehouse locations. It can manage, yes, the production planning across different warehouses locations. Can track and report quality levels by production center and product and the customer levels. Can the ability to monitor and trace the any assembly components or sub-assembly throughput the supply chain real time. Using these clouds today is one of the main tools used today for managing the supply chain for storage a certain type of a huge size of data, and we can achieve different type of benefits for managing the supply chain like we are mentioned in this type of page. What about for the drones? Drones here, it's one of the drone applications are being implemented already in most of giant companies today. It's which are adopting these drones in the first phase of supply chain management for obtaining first the raw material. This is in the first, okay. We can depend for drones by managing the system of supply chain for achieving different type of benefits like given here in this page. It can move small items quickly, reducing the need for forklifts or possibly replacing the conveyor systems. Often used to transport boxes around the distribution centers. Yes, this services can be achieved and to benefit by using these drones. Can monitor the road conditions. That can monitor the construction slowdown and other hazards while reporting the information of logistics managers. Who can quickly select alternative shipping routes. It is very important to track all the system through while reporting the information to logistics managers. Yes, he can take another take a quickly decision to select another alternative shipping routes to transport the shipments. Yes, it can speed up operations and decrease the delivery times, like what's happened in the Amazon company, which can depend today on using this type of drones to deliver their products with 30 minutes as delivery time to their customers, and while cutting down the supply chain cost, okay. And also it can benefit for checking the inventory at anywhere in the warehouse by using the tools which are defined in the chapter 3 as the RFID system, and using the barcode readers which can offer better inventory management. Also, drones can be benefit to move from warehouse to warehouse with a very simple way in moments, and deliver this information to integrate warehouse management software. Okay. Today there is a new industrial revolution called Industry 4. Okay. This is the can lead for achieving different types of benefits in the area of transportation. This will lead for rapid manufacturing, advanced robotics, digitalization of supply chain by using the Internet of Things and big data. At the end, one of this type of technology platform which are used today, here the global trans delivers abbreviatory technology platform and one-stop integrated solution that seamlessly connects shippers with carriers. Do you understand? Connects the shippers with carriers, freight agents, and global trans logistics services. Okay, to connect between shippers with carriers through sharing the products, this is will be lead to achieve different type of benefits, like here the real-time visibility and the control of supply chain performance, lower shipping cost and reduced overhead, advanced machine learning to analyze the shipping data to optimize the decision making, and faster, more efficient way to facilitate transporting the products through the logistics management. By ending the previous page, we can say that the transportation chapter is finished now, and inshallah we will meet again in the next chapter according to inventory inventory management. And now, assalamu alaikum.